Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel, friends. If you are not subscribed my YouTube channel yet, do subscribe it today and press the bell icon to receive notification about my new videos. In this video, we will see how to install Windows Server 2019. So in this video, we will see the step-by-step process to install Windows Server 2019. For this, I have created Windows Server 2019 bootable USB using the Windows Server 2019 ISO file, which I downloaded from my Visual Studio subscription. And after plugging in that bootable USB, I got this setup window, and from here I can start installing Windows Server 2019. So here I can make few selections like language, time and currency, keyboard, and then I click on next button here and then install now to launch the actual setup wizard. After that, I am asked to enter a product key, but I will do the activation part later. So I will select here. I don't have a product key option. Windows Server 2019 is an LTS release, so it have a standard core and desktop experience variants. And the standard core takes very less space, but you have to manage it entirely with the command prompt, while this desktop edition takes relatively more space on the hard disk, but you can use all of the features and apps using the graphical interface it provides. So for this guide, I am selecting the desktop experience edition and clicking on next. And after that, I have to accept the license terms. Since we are making a clean install here, so I will select a custom type of install here and select the hard drive partition where I want to install the machine. After that, I have clicked on next. And as usual, like in Windows client edition as well, the installation screen has been appeared, and after a few moments the installation is about to complete and the system is about to reboot. One thing I should mention here that I have disconnected this machine from the internet while installing this server edition. I will later connect it to activate the machine. So as we can see that it is about to finish the installation and reboot itself. So as you can see, the reboot screen is here. So I will click on restart now. After that, system restarted and it performed some post installation task such as starting services, getting devices ready, and making sure that everything is connected and remains connected so that you can finally use the operating system. After that, system rebooted again and in few moments I received this screen where I have to customize settings. So username here is administrator, you can't change it, but you can create a new password for it, which should be at least 8 characters long. So I'll just create a password and re-enter that to confirm it. Once this is done, the primary administrator account is completed and you can click on finish, and the settings should be finalized now. So we are on the lock screen and we can press Ctrl Alt Delete to unlock the system and type in the administrator password we just created now. So here it is. We have first time arrived to the desktop after making clean install of Windows Server 2019. So after a few moments when I connected this system to internet, you can see that the system is connected to internet and I have Windows Server Manager launched itself, and it will launch automatically whenever you start the server. So you can manage the entire server using the Server Manager. You can use the add roles and features to add new features to this server, and you can also check the videos on the card already mentioned how you can add new features to this server. We will close the Server Manager at the moment, and now I will do the activation part which I left earlier. For that I will go to Settings app. And as you can see that in the Settings app there is a bottom line, Windows is not activated. Activate Windows now, because if you do not activate Windows, you will not be able to personalize the system. For example, if you go to Personalization, you can see that you cannot change the background and anything that will personalize your system unless you activate Windows. So I will just click on the activate Windows now and then change product key. And under enter a product key, you have to type in a genuine product key you have obtained from the retailer or Visual Studio subscription or wherever you got your license from. So type in your genuine product key here and click on the next button. After that, click on the activate button. If your genuine product key is okay, valid, your system should be activated within few moments. Make sure you remain connected to the internet while activating your system. So as you can see that the system is now activated. So here it is shown that Windows is activated, and since it is activated, I can now personalize this system and make use of all its features without any restrictions. So this is all about how you can install Windows Server 2019 and then activate it. So that's it for now. Thanks for watching this video. If you found it helpful, do like it, share it, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos.